let's take a look at how to assemble your new distinct door. Be sure to follow the instruction booklet as well. Before beginning, be sure you have all the necessary parts and tools required for the installation process. You'll find them listed in the instruction manual. The distinct door can easily be purchased, transported, and assembled by as few as one or two people. A simple numbering system makes designing your door a breeze. The distinct door comes with pre-applied locating pins and gaskets. Insert the locating pins from the left jamb into the alignment holes in the sill. Drive 4 assembly screws into each corner of the sill, then drive 3 assembly screws into each corner of the head. Position the installation flange with the nub on the long leg facing the exterior. Apply pressure on the flat side of the installation flange until the part is flush to the profile. This step is only needed for new construction applications. Attach the flange gasket by exposing the adhesive and folding it over the nail flange. Repeat this on all corners. Pivot the door into the opening. Apply silicone on the head and jambs of the installation flange. If you're installing as new construction, in this video, we're installing as a replacement door. Make sure to apply silicone on the sill for replacement applications. We chose to install the keeper after putting the frame into place. The keeper can also be installed along with the handle towards the end. Pre-punched holes allow you to easily place the adjustable keeper. Attach 3 fixed panel spacers from the hardware bag and locate 2 of these 8 inches from the edge of the panel and 1 in the center. Push the fixed panel riser to the jamb until it makes contact. Drive 3 fixed panel riser screws into the pre-punched holes on the riser ends. Drive the 3rd screw into the center of the riser. This is done without a pre-punched hole. Swing the fixed panel into the frame, aligning it to the exterior sash rail. Push the panel into the jamb pocket of the frame. Make sure the panel is flush to the exposed end of the riser. Place the fixing clip against the channel of the panel and the channel of the riser. Drive 3 clip screws onto the riser and the panel. Next, place the fixing clip into the top part of the channel on the fixed panel. Screw into the fixed panel and also where the fixing clip meets the head of the frame. Use the screws provided in the riser clip bag to secure the panel to the frame. Use the weather stripping channel as a guide and screw in at a slight angle into the fixed panel. Snap the interlock into the fixed panel channel. Verify that the surface of the interlock is flush to the riser. Use caution when installing. This part is non-removable. Once the interlock on the fixed panel is installed, secure it to the panel by driving screws through pre-punched holes on the top and bottom of the interlock accessory piece. To further secure, add 2 more screws near the center. Snap the interlock cover into the groove of the interlock. Snap a plug into the pre-punched hole at the bottom of the interlock. Repeat this process for the top hole. place the end cap over the end of the riser. Make sure the holes on the end cap align with those of the riser. Insert the sill pad onto the sill and slide it underneath the bottom of the interlock to where it touches the tab of the end cap. Drive two screws through the visible holes on the sill pad. Install the interlock onto the operating panel in the same fashion used with the fixed panel. Snap the interlock cover into the groove of the interlock. From the interior of the opening, guide the operating panel to sit on the roller track. Using the adjustment screw, you can rise and lower the operating panel. Move the operable panel into full open position and slide the head pad into the head cavity. Attach the pad with one screw. Install the jam filler on the exterior pocket on the handle side of the sliding glass door. Then install on the interior pocket. Install the sill bumper into the frame by pressing it into the opening pocket. Repeat this step for the head bumper. Install the handle following the instructions that are included with it. The keeper may need to slide up and down to correct full engagement. Thanks for watching. We hope you enjoy your new door.